Can I ask you something, Carlos? You see that I'm taking it for too long. Please stop me, okay? Feel free. Good morning, everybody. For those who couldn't attend the meeting yesterday, my name is Jorge Coyo. I'm from the GIFI Community Network in Catalonia, Spain. And what I would like to talk to you today is about some ideas we have been implementing in the past years for the economic sustainability of our community network. This is summarized around the compensations model, which is a mechanism that we are putting in place and that I will explain you in detail now. So just for starting, there will be a warning. And then I would like to discuss the network layers and telco business models just to put ourselves on the map. Afterwards, just a brief discussion about the commons in telecommunications networks. Then, who are the players in this community network in GIFI? And finally, we'll go to the compensation model we are putting into practice and see what are the objectives of this mechanism. So let's start with this warning. As you can read on our website, GIFI is a bottom-up, citizenship-driven, technological, social, and economic project based on a commons model for the network. I'm going to focus only on the sustainability in the economic part of the project. Of course, we have also problems and we have to work a lot on the sustainability, the social and technological part of the project, but this might be another time, right? And another warning is that this is just for you to see how we implement these compensation models as a means for economic sustainability while we foster professional or commercial operation on top of a community network. I know of many community networks that when we talk about them, we talk about commercial exploitation on top of the network, they say no. This is the case for, I don't know, Freifunk in Germany or Linux in Italy. These are two community networks I kind of know. And that they do not see commercial operation on top of the network. However, we do. And the idea is that, well, we get to see this, try to understand it. If you happen to put anything into practice, please let us know, because we would like to see if what we are doing can be applied to other places or not, or what are the challenges. We usually think of networks in general, telecommunication networks, and we like to divide them into layers. Let's start by the bottom. In our case, we use wireless technology but also fiber optics, so there is a passive layer of infrastructure that is there, like fiber optics or DACs or trenches. In the case of Wi-Fi, this is not so clear because the air is like free to air, but eventually your networks might end up using fiber optics or other sort of technology other than Wi-Fi, so it's good to have it in mind. In any case, we all have this active network infrastructure layer, which comprises routers and electronics, and also the operation of the network itself. So people are putting effort and time into the maintenance and operation. Once we have this working, on top we add services like, I don't know, voice or internet connection or data storage or file sharing, whatever. And these services are meant for end users, which could be individuals or public organizations or enterprises, whatever. And finally, on top, there are the end users. In the case of GIFI, these end users can also be volunteers or maybe not. in other community networks, these end users are always volunteers. These network layers can be managed with some very well-known business models in the telcos sector. For instance, the one on the right, the black one, is a vertically integrated operator which owns all the layers of the infrastructure, and on top of this network, he is the only one providing services to end customers. This is the case, for instance, in Spain. Almost all the big ISPs are vertically integrated operators. They own everything and they provide services only on top of their network. However, there are other models like, for instance, we could see the ones that are divided in three blocks, in which an operator manages one part of the infrastructure, then another manages the active layer, and then other companies offer services. This would be the case of SIEM, for instance. Oh, here is bigger. So in the end, there are several models, at least for the Spanish case or the European case, which is the one I'm used to. In any case, what Giphy proposes is something a little bit different. We also have these layers we show in the picture. However, in Giphy, the passive infrastructure, if we have any, in our case, yes, we have fiber optics and so on, and ducts and trenches. And also, the active part of the network, this is routers and wireless links and switches and antennas and so on, they are managed as a common pool resource. This is a set of infrastructures where everybody is contributing and participating. And furthermore, this commons infrastructure, this pool resource, is managed in a collaborative way. This is depending on the geographic area, many participants are in control of managing the network covering that part of the country. And finally, once we have everything running in this common pool resource model and in this collaborative management, we add the services on top. And in the case of Giphy, these services can be either commercial, so professionally offered, or community offered. The main difference will be that, of course, the commercial ones are in exchange for a monthly fee or some kind of subscription, and then the community services are mostly offered for free on a best effort basis. Now, we usually talk about the commons, and this concept of the commons is quite old, maybe as old as humanity. There are many definitions, and most of them are meant for natural resources, like the one you can see on top, or there are more general ones, like the second one. And my question is, does the commons concept apply to network infrastructure? And I think it's, for us, it might be quite obvious. Yes, we are part of community networks, and in our networks, the infrastructure, routers, devices, etc., are these commons. So, when we think of the whole community network, it's not only about these devices and infrastructure, but also about the players that are around interacting with the network and between them. I will focus on the case of Giphy, which is the one I know the best. This picture might not apply for all community networks, of course, but what we would see in all of them is that this network infrastructure in commons should be in the middle. Now, all around this infrastructure, what can we see? Well, for sure, there are the volunteers. Volunteers, as I stated in the first or the second slide, If GIF is a citizenship-driven community network, volunteers must appear somewhere, and they have a central role in GIFing. As contributors to the infrastructure and users of the infrastructure. Besides that, we also have professionals that operate on top of the network and also contribute resources to the network, but at the same time, they extract resources from the network for their personal, for their business profit. We will see now how this is made. And to make everything work, in some cases in GIFI, there is also the public administration in some areas helping or contributing to the commons infrastructure. And overall, there is a neutral, non-partisan, and regulated authority that all the members in the community network trust. And in this case, this is the GIFI Foundation. Under the Spanish regulation, under the Spanish law, foundations have very strict rules for what they can do and what they cannot. And in the case of GIFI, the mission of the foundation is to take care for the free, open, neutral network, nothing more. This means that all the participants can trust this authoritative entity in terms of regulation and arbitration and conflict resolution. So in the end, what this authority gives is the common core resource governance. So the tools to manage the interaction between all these participants with the network infrastructure. During the previous day, I could talk to many of you, and in some cases, your network infrastructure is still too small or too incipient as to be worried about those things I'm going to explain, but I guess that at some point your networks will grow so big that you may not even know all the participants in the network. This is the case of GIFI. I just know a small percentage of all the participants in the network. At some point, you may be sharing resources or infrastructure with people that are not part of your community, but maybe they are in a neighboring community or even more neighboring of a neighboring community. How do we make it in GIFI when an infrastructure is shared so that it is done in a fair way? This means if I am contributing to an infrastructure, I'm very happy that other people use it, but if they are making money out of it, there should be a fair way so that I recover my investment and I'm not just paying other people's parties, right? This is what we call the compensation system in GIFI. GIFI is an open network in the sense of transparency, so every investment that volunteers do can be declared on the website, and every investment that professionals do on the network, it must be declared on the website. This is accessible to everybody. Furthermore, there are some agreed criteria for declaring these investments, like agreed prices and costs. To help accountability, and there are some rules on how detailed the information must be. So, in the end, what we have is that, let's take the month of May, which is our trend, we get to a geographic area where many participants are using the commons network, especially professionals doing commercial activity, and we calculate how much they have contributed in terms of investment and maintenance to the network, and we also calculate how many resources they have used out of this network. This is basically bandwidth to the internet, but any other resource could be taken into account, like, I don't know, electricity or renting a space for a tower and for putting antennas. But we sum all the costs and all the investments, and then we make some calculations to see how much every participant must contribute to this common pool to compensate for the deviation between investment and benefits they are having. What's the ideal situation? Here you can see that there are four participants, actually five participants, sorry, and some of them are using more resources than they are contributing in investment or in maintenance and so on. This is not an issue. At the end of the month, we make the calculations and we compensate the expenses between all the participants. Actually, it's not that the participants start sending bills one each other, but the IFI Foundation, as the authoritative entity, makes a global sum and manages all these efforts. This is also a sustainability activity for the foundation, but it's not the main goal of the organization. When I said that everything was public, it means that all these numbers here that can barely be seen are accessible on the website. So you can see on your region how much investment there has been. In the end, what we want to attain is a sustainable design to and based on the collaborative economy, which was described by the Nobel Prize in Economy, Elinor Ostrom. So we want to achieve this sustainable design so that the network is kept operated in a fair way, so that it allows volunteers to participate and to feel comfortable, and it allows professionals to earn their money in a fair and sustainable way. So the situation for Spain and for Europe is basically a free market in the telecommunications area. However, what we try to push from the foundation is that this free market in GIFI is non-speculative, because our goal is to provide affordable and meaningful internet access, not to become rich and, I don't know, be the next Bill Gates, right? So instead of just earning money from within the foundation, we encourage participants to reinvest the benefits of their activity in building more network, connecting more people, and if possible, reducing the prices. We have seen that this is a win-win ecosystem. Having a shared infrastructure is much more efficient than the other models in which every participant has his own infrastructure, and we end up duplicating or having everything three or four times deployed. This is quite common in some cities in Europe, where you see the infrastructure of all the ISPs in the city, one on top of the other, and you look at it and you think, wow, if all these cables would be in rural areas, everything would be much better serviced. Another thing important here in the compensation model is that everything must be accountable, and therefore there must be a consensus on how this accountability is made. So, for instance, ISPs in an area decide that an hour of their work time is valued at some price. And this should be last one. How is this really implemented, this compensations model? Well, there are monthly meetings in every area where professional activity is being performed in Giphy, or so we are trying to do, where all the participants meet afternoon, for instance, and they check what they have declared, what every other participant is declaring as an investment. They acknowledge it, or they discuss if this is properly implemented or not, or if it's true, or if the infrastructure is not performing as expected. And all these balances are made. Who's participating? These meetings are open for everybody to join. This includes, of course, participants. And who should be there? For sure, the operators, the professionals offering services on the network. And there, they have some duties. They have rights and they have duties, which I think this slide will be shared to you so you can check it later in a more calm way. For sure, there has to be this entity, this trusted entity that is arbitrating the process. And this entity also has some rights and duties. Among them, well, the rights, but especially the duties. It has to be transparent. It has to foreshore the consensus among all the participants. And then, optionally, in these meetings, there could also be any volunteer, of course, and the public administration and investors who are putting money in the infrastructure. Why? Because they have the rights. There's a mistake there. They have the vote and the voice right to give their opinion, because in the end, it's them contributing to the infrastructure. The global objective of all this compensation model is to achieve long-term sustainability in the community networks ecosystem. Why? Because we have seen that at some point when the network starts growing and new participants join and we don't know each other, well, confusion may arise. And the spirit of the network, which has to be free and open and internet, is somehow lost. So what we like to do is to work in terms of small projects that end in a recursive growth, in a feedback that fosters recursive growth. So let's imagine that we have a geographic area in which we want to deploy network in the commons model. So we will need first see if there are users wanting to connect to the network. Or we will have to see the mechanisms to acquire these users and engage them into the community network. Once we have them, there will be some investment to be made so that they can be connected to the network. This is basically infrastructure, deploying devices and so on. And once, this doesn't work. Okay, and once the network is working, this operation should generate the income to sustain it in the economic terms. Then afterwards, we can implement a second phase. So instead of just staying there, we can continue iterating in the same way, so that a project leads to the sustainability and fosters new projects that will lead to more projects, and so on and so forth. So I think I'm already ahead of the bad time. I didn't say anything. Thanks for listening, and if you want to discuss, yeah.